decreases. Means coffee will become expensive. Coffee will become expensive as compared to tea. So consumer will decrease demand of coffee. I hope all of you have understood. Now we can say that there is positive means price of substitute good increases. Price of substitute good increases means demand of given commodity also increases. And price of substitute good decreases, demand of given commodity also decreases. Means we can say that there is positive relation or direct relation between price of substitute good and demand of coffee. See, I hope all of you have understood. See, but how will you write? How will you write? See, try to understand with the help of numerical example. Suppose price of tea is here in rupee and demand of coffee. Is it visible or not? Yeah, is it visible? See, price of tea. Suppose price is tea. Initial price of tea is rupee 10. Initial price of tea is rupee 10. And initial demand of coffee is suppose 1 unit. 1 coffee. See, now price of tea increases from 10 to 20. Now see, price of tea increases from 10 to 20, it means coffee will become cheaper in the market. So consumer will increase demand of coffee and consumer will not prefer demand of tea because tea will become expensive in the market because of increase in price of tea. See, now price of tea increases from rupee 10 to rupee 20. Now coffee will become cheaper as compared to tea. So consumer will increase demand of coffee from 1 unit to 2 unit. I hope this is clear. See, suppose initial price of tea is rupee 20. Initial price of tea is rupee 20. Now price of tea decreases from 20 to 10. Now and initial quantity of coffee is suppose initial quantity of coffee is 2 unit at rupee 20. Quantity of coffee is 2 unit. See, now price of tea decreases from 20 to 10. Then coffee will become expensive as compared to tea in market. So consumer will decrease demand of coffee from 2 unit to 1 unit. You can take any value of price, you can take any value of units, but always try to show positive relation or direct relation. Means price of substitute good increases, then demand of given commodity also increases. Price of substitute good decreases, then demand of given commodity also decreases. I hope all of you have understood substitute good, definition of substitute good, and what is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of substitute good. Demand of given commodity and price of substitute good. See, how will you write explanation of this? See, an increase in the price of an increase in the price of rupee 10 to rupee 20. Now coffee will become cheaper as compared to tea. So consumer will increase demand of coffee from 1 unit to 2 unit. From 1 unit to 2 unit. I hope this is clear. This is clear. See, suppose initial price of tea is rupee 20. Initial price of tea is rupee 20. Now price of tea decreases from 20 to 10. Now and initial quantity of coffee is 2 unit at rupee 20. Quantity of coffee is 2 units. See, now price of tea decreases from 20 to 10. Then coffee will become expensive as compared to tea in market. So consumer will decrease demand of coffee from 2 unit to 1 unit. You can take any value of price, you can take any value of units, but always try to show positive relation or direct relation means price of substitute good increases, then demand of given commodity also increases. Price of substitute good decreases, then demand of given commodity also decreases. I hope all of you have understood substitute good, definition of substitute good, and what is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of substitute good. Demand of given commodity and price of substitute good. See, how will you write explanation of this? See, an increase in the price of substitute good. Suppose I'm taking here substitute good as a tea. Substitute good like price of tea. I hope all of you are understanding. See, an increase in the price of substitute good. Substitute good means price of tea. I'm taking here tea as a substitute good. Then it leads to an increase in the demand of given commodity. See, you can write here good. See, substitute good, you can write here given good. It's up to you. Demand of, because I'm taking a price of tea, so I have to take here demand of coffee. Increase in the demand of given commodity means demand of coffee. And decrease in the price of substitute good means price of tea, then it leads to decrease in the डिमांड ऑफ गिवन कमोडिटी. गिवन कमोडिटी. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सी क्वेश्चन इज देयर, एक्सप्लेन सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड. एक्सप्लेन सब्स्टिट्यूट गुड with the help of example. Explain the substitute with the help of example. Then first of all you will write definition. Then after you will write this example. Suppose if you are taking here price of coffee, then you will take here demand of tea. And I hope, suppose we are taking here price of Coke, then you will take here demand of Pepsi. So I hope all of you have understood substitute good. So what is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of substitute good? Means positive relationship. Please pause the video and note it down. Now next part of price of related goods, as you know that price of related goods are two types. First is substitute goods and second is complementary goods. Now we have discussed what is substitute goods, what are substitute goods, but now we are going to discuss complementary goods. See, what are complementary goods? Complementary goods are those goods which are used together to satisfy a particular want. For example, petrol and car, both will use together, and tea and sugar. So these are the examples of complementary goods. Now after this we will understand different means relation between demand of given commodity and price of complementary goods. See here, suppose I'm taking here price of petrol. I am taking here demand of car, means car will be considered as given commodity and petrol will be considered as complementary, because I am taking here price of petrol and I am taking here demand of car, so car will be considered as given commodity and petrol will be considered as a complementary good. Suppose price of petrol increases. See, price of petrol increases means running cost of car will increase, means demand of car will decrease because of increase in running cost of car. Suppose price of petrol decreases means running cost of car will decrease. Means you can say running cost of car will decrease, it means demand for car will increase. You can say that there is inverse or negative relationship between price of complementary good and demand of given good. I hope all of you have understood what are complementary goods. Complementary goods are those goods which are used together to satisfy a particular want. And what is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of complementary good? Means inverse or negative relationship. Suppose price of petrol increases means running cost of car will increase, then the consumer will decrease demand of car. And suppose price of petrol decrease means running cost of car will decrease means demand will increase demand of car. So there is inverse or negative relationship between demand of given commodity and price of complementary good. But see, what is the relationship between price of substitute good and demand of given commodity? Positive relation. Means positive relation exists between price of substitute good and demand of given good. But inverse relation exists between price of complementary good and demand of given good. I hope price of related goods are clear. Means price of related goods are two type. First is substitute and second is complementary. And what is the relation between price of substitute and given commodity? Positive relation. It means substitute good has positive relation and complementary good has a negative relation. I hope all of you have understood. You will explain complementary goods like substitute goods. I hope all of you have understood. Please.